In the previous example, rooms were displayed. Now let's show how to create and work with them. Let's activate the first floor plan BIM section. Looking at the first floor plan, there are a couple of spaces that don't have rooms defined. Selecting BIM room from the quad or entering in the command line enables the ability to select a point in a space to create the room. The room must be enclosed by walls to be created. We'll select BIM room again to add the second room. The room tag displayed includes a name, area, and a default room number that is sequential. These properties can be changed as well. Now let's select the two rooms to add a few properties. We'll give them both a name of circulation. We'll select the east building. We'll select the first floor. We can also check that they're on the structure browser where they should be. In the east building on the first floor and defined as rooms. However, we didn't associate a department for the rooms. We'll select them and enter Design in Department. Now the rooms shift to that department. Let's see what happens when we move a wall between two rooms. Looking at the plan, the intent of the design was for all the larger rooms to be able to be opened and joined into one. We've learned we still need more space, so we need to decrease the size of the conference room and increase the size of the overflow design room. The wall moves, and the two rooms on either side will update. Each room is checking if its bounding walls have been adjusted, and if they have, the boundary is updated as well as the area value on each room tag.